In this sample, we're going to teach you how to recapture design intent in TopSolid 7. We'll begin by importing a PDF file directly into our PDM project tree. We'll rename it real quick. And here, this PDF file contains all the engineering information for this standard component that we downloaded off the web. You can double-click on it to access it at any time. Next, we'll go ahead and import the parasolid file for this component. We'll ask TopSolid 7 to translate the assembly structure, and like that, we now have the assembly for our hydraulic cylinder. Next, we want to capture the design intent. To begin with, we'll show you that it's just a simple assembly right now, and then we'll go to Mechanism and create a new mechanism. We'll begin by creating a rigid group of elements. This first group will be for the moving elements. We'll call it shaft, and we'll select the three components. From there, we'll describe a mechanical joint. In this case, we'll choose prismatic, we'll choose our two objects, and we'll describe a distance, and even describe limits. From here, we can create a configuration and try it out. And now we can drag the hydraulic cylinder to its maximum stroke. And like that, we've just recaptured the design intent of the hydraulic cylinder. We'll save it and close it, and next, we'll go insert it in an assembly. To insert, you just drag and drop it out of your design tree. And now from here, we'll start applying assembly constraints. You'll notice that right now, the part is purple. Purple means under constrained. As we add this last constraint, you'll notice it turns blue. That means fully constrained. Yet notice the hydraulic cylinder is still purple. That's because its mechanism is still free to move. And like that, we've included this downloaded component and recaptured its design intent.